Good morning, Post Construction.
Yeah, who's speaking?
Wilma.
Is Joe, is he the owner?
Yeah.
Is he there?
Are you a salesman?
No, I need to talk to him about a problem I have.
Okay, he just don't like to talk to salesmen. Hang on just a minute.
All right.
He is one romantic soul, isn't he? It's Doug Stone and Maiden for Loving.
Hello.
Who is this?
This Joe.
Listen, this is Roy D. Mercer. I'm calling you from Elk City.
Yeah?
Listen, I was in there, my boy was in there the other day, and got some gas in there.
Yes, sir?
We had a problem with it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, he got out there on the interstate out there, East Elk City, and it broke down.
Huh.
Yeah, it's bad gas.
Well, boy, Roy, I sure ain't had no trouble.
Well, I tell you what, that ain't the half of it. He was out there trying to thumb a ride into town to get his car towed off.
Yeah.
And a busload of hippies pull over and give him a ride.
Yeah.
Well, it ain't funny.
Well, what happened?
Well, I guarantee you, they got him back there in that van and got beer in him and got him hopped up on that marijuana.
Well, my God.
Well, it was. It's awful.
Well, Roy, I'm sure sorry. I'll just complain to my gas jobber and let him pass the word on.
Well, there's going to be a little more than a complaint involved because they went in there and drove him into Weatherford, and they convinced him to go in there, and they robbed his restaurant there yesterday.
Well, hell.
That's what I said.
I sure don't know what to tell you.
Well, I guarantee you, it all boils down to bad gas.
Yeah.
If he hadn't think about that gas there and hadn't broke down, them hippies wouldn't have picked him up, and he wouldn't have been involved in no robbery.
Boy, Roy, I sure can't help you on none of that.
Well, then you're going to get an ass-whooping then.
Well, that's fine. Just come on.
I'm coming down there today.
Well, I'm sure sorry to tell you, but I can't do that. I can't run his life for him.
Well, you gonna be there and be ready for an ass-whooping?
Just whatever it takes. I'll be around.
Because I guarantee you, I had to tow his truck in there.
Well, Roy, I'm not going to be liable for none of his problems, personal problems. I'm sure sorry about it.
Well, by God, he wouldn't be doing that if he didn't have broke down out there.
Well, I don't even know you, so I'm...
Well, you're getting ready to know me.
That'll be fine.
Yeah, how long has it been since you had a good old country ass whooping?
Well, I don't know. I just tell you what, you come up here, you'll probably be in jail.
What do you look like?
I don't know. I don't have time for you, sir.
What do you... What kind...
I thought he knew who you were. You say it's a friend of yours?
Mm-hmm.
I thought he knew who you were.
No, I ain't talked to him in 15 years. I may not talk to him for another 15 after this.
Good morning, Post Construction.
I was talking to Joe when I got cut off her.
Okay, he's in his Suburban, and he said if anybody called for him, to just have him call him there.
Is this Joe?
Yeah.
Listen, this is Mr. Mercer from Elk City calling you.
Yes, sir.
And I damn sure need to get a hold of you and get this took care of. Listen, my boy had a vintage 68 Camaro SS. It's silver and black.
What'd you get your lawyer there, Roy?
Well, you may want to need to get you a doctor.
I'd be all right.
Well, I guarantee you now, we got some bills, some towing bills to get took care of, and he's accused, he's accessory to robbery there at Jerry's restaurant in Wallace.
Well, maybe I'll send him up.
Well, now then we got another problem to deal with. He don't look good in orange. It ain't funny.
Well.
Listen, I guarantee you now one of them old boys that was in that van that hippies that picked him up.
Yeah.
I think he said that he was from Tulsa. He said his name was Brent.
He'd be the type to do that.
Well, that might have been a long-haired feller, kind of heavy set.
Yeah, kind of silly.
Well, it's damn silly.
Sounds kind of like you, too. Are you doing?
How in the world are you doing, Joe?
Oh, my God, how are you?
I'm fine.
I ain't seen you since I had a baby.
I know it. I know it.
Who's there with you?
This is my partner, Phil Stone.
Well, you two somebody out of something to do or what? Well, I hope it's censored. Oh, damn, I tell you what, I've never been. I'd like to say old Brent, he don't ever run out of nothing to say, does he?
No, he doesn't, that's for sure.
Damn, I tell you what, well, send me a recording of that if you spend the money.
Yeah. Well, I don't know that you're worth it, Joe.
Well, come down there and whip my ass one. I'd let him whip me if he'd just come down here.
Joe, well, I'm not sure, but what you might be related to Roy, actually.
What's the matter? There's a bunch of idiots out here dislike him. Y'all didn't miss it by far at all. I thought it was a normal day.
Boy, my sensor finger's going to be sore.
That's right. He done wore out his cuckoo over there.
How many kids does Mr. Britt have on him now?
Well, I got three. How many did you pop out?
Oh, I got three, too. My made a slave out of me.